For interfacing 16x2 LCD, we have to assign some pins from microcontroller 8051. Totally 11 pins are required to interface LCD with microcontroller. Out of them, 8 are data lines DB0 to DB7. These are all called data out lines that should be connected to. I am assigning port 1 for connecting the data lines. Okay, 8 lines are over. Remaining three lines I have to connect. For that, I am taking P2.0, P2.1 and P2.2. So these three lines are connected to the control signals of the LCD. RS is the pin number 4 of LCD, nothing but register select pin. I am connecting this to P2.0, R by WR bar, read or write control pin. This line is connected to port 2.1. Enable pin is connected to port 2.2. It can be seen in this diagram. So it is an interface diagram. So port 1.0 to 1.7 is allocated to connect to data lines from pin number 7 to 14 in LCD. These three are control signals. 4 is nothing but RS line that is connected to P2.0. R by WR bar is connected to P2.1. Enable pin is connected to P2.2. Next we see how to program, how to write a program for printing the text GO. There are two characters I am going to print now. For that I have to write the initialization code first. So these codes number 38, 0E, 01, 06 and 84. These five different codes are called initialization codes. Before using the LCD we have to make ready them to receive any bytes and display properly. Hence, we have some LCD code commands. These are discussed in the LCD part 1 video. Okay, you refer there. So, mainly we need minimum four code commands for the initialization. So, that is first one, number 38. So, these are all, number 38 is called the function set code. 0 is called display on off control code. 01 is clear display code. 06 is entry mode set code. And 84 is the display address where we are going to display the text GO. Okay, so this is the address here. So these are the basic initialization code that should be written before the main program. Now we see how I am getting 38. So it's a function set code. These are described in the part 1 video. You just refer. Even though I am saying in the function set we are declaring what is the data length of your length of the data, how many lines you are going to display and what type of font you are going to display. These things we are putting some values. We are getting 0x38. So this value is presented here, 38. Similarly, next display on off control. Here we are setting the entire display, either it should be on or off, cursor on or off, blinking of the cursor on and off. These informations we are feeding here. It is a format. When we are substituting value, we get 0x0e. So that is mentioned here. Similarly, the next is clear display code. So for this we have this format. So this here we have a fixed value. There is no need for configuration. So D7 to D1 we are having 0 value. D0 is the 1 value. Hence we are getting hexadecimal value 0x01. So that is presented here. Next, entry mode set. For entry mode set we have this option. So how to enter the text from right to left or left to right. So these options it configured here. So from this we are getting 0x06h. So that value is presented here. The last one is the 84. The 84 is nothing but the position of the text where going to be displayed. So in our example, I have said I am going to print GO, text GO. So where it can start printing, from first location or in the first line, first location, or in the second line or somewhere location. Here I am deciding to print from 84. That means 80, 81, 82, 83, 84. So here I can print the GO value. So for that I am designing where to print. I have to give some commands. That command is nothing but the address command. Okay. For sending these commands to LCD one by one, first we have to perform the moving the immediate value to the accumulator. Then we use two types of subroutines. One is for writing the command to the LCD. Then we need some delay to move the second value. Now we see what is this subroutine do, what the, this subroutine do. So whenever we write the command to the LCD, we have to make things, three control signals are there. RS should be made as 0, R by W or W bar should be made as 0 because write operation. Similarly, enable pin should be made as high to low. So these three things can be done here, but every time we are making the similar thing, every time we are moving some command control to the LCD. Hence, if we write in the main program, it will take, it, the program will be very longer. Hence, we are putting in the subroutine. Now we see the subroutine, how the program is written here. Look at this subroutine. First of all, the 38 value is moved to accumulator. That value is moved to P1. So P1 is the data line. P1 is the port from which the data lines are connected to LCD. So the data will be available in port 1's output pin. But we have to latch this into the LCD so that we can make the arrangements. For that, we have to perform three operations. First one, RS, register select pin, should be made 0 by writing the instruction clear P2.0. R by WR bar is equal to 0 for write operation because we are writing the code. So clear P2.1 should be written. So next we have to do the enable pin should be made high to low. For that, first we have to make this pin as 1 by using the instruction set B P2.2. After some delay, I will clear the pin. So 1, then 0. In between, we have some delay. Hence, we get the high to low transition pulse. So when this made, the code is latched to the LCD. So this this code, nearly it is of 7 or 8 lines. If I write every time in the main program, the program will be very lengthier. Hence, I am writing this as a subroutine. Every time we send the code 380E010684. So every time we send the command code, we have to call the subroutine command write every time with some delay. So that's all about the initialization command codes. Next, we go to the main picture of your program. So this is the main task of your program. First of all, we move the character G to the accumulator. Then we call the data write subroutine. After that, we call the delay program. So here what we do, sending the data G printed in location 0x84. The 84 is already given in the initialization code. The next, we move the O value to the accumulator. Then we call the data write subroutine and delay routine. At the last, we use the jump, short jump instruction to the label here. So after finishing all the things, it will roll around here. Okay. Hence, we get the text in the LCD as 0. So what about data write subroutine? Now we see. So this is the data write subroutine. So first of all, what value G is I am going to display. So the G is already available in the accumulator. Then it is moved to the port 1. So when we move to the port 1, it is connected to data lines. Hence the data should be latched into the LCD in the data register. Usually the codes are moved to the instruction register. Data are moved to the data register. This is classified by the pin RS is equal to 1. So here in code write, we use command write, we use RS is equal to 0. Hence, the code will be moved to the instruction register. When we make RS is equal to 1, it moved to the data register. So we have to set the P2.0 here. Remaining things are as usual, as handled in the command write operation. That means R by WR bar is equal to 0 for write operation. Then we have to make enable pin high to low transition. Hence, the data is latched to the data register. This is the delay routine. We usually use one or two registers to have some values and decrement the value up to it meets 0. Here we have decided to take R4 and R3 register. So the R4 is the inner loop. First of all, it loads 50 to R3 and 255. These are decimal values loaded into the corresponding registers. So first of all, this instruction decrement and jump if not 0. So as long as this becomes a 0 value, it don't go to the next line. It rotates up to here. Okay, so not 0 value, it decrements first, it becomes 254, and the condition is true. Hence it goes to the here, and it again performs a decrement operation, becomes 253. Similarly, it goes up to 0, then only it come out to the next line. So here it decrements from R3 from 50 to 0. So every time it decrements, it goes to the inner rotation of 255. Okay, so we get the delay of 50 into 255 times. We get the delay here. This is also a LCD interfacing program. Here also we are going to display the text GO in the LCD, but we are going to use some different technique. That is, whenever the data or code, command code sent to the LCD, we use some delay value, then we again send the second data. But here we are not going to use the delay. Instead, we are going to check the busy flag. So the busy flag is the very important flag handled by the LCD. Usually when LCD receives any data or command code from the microcontroller, it starts, it makes busy flag, BF is equal to 1, then starts data processing. That means printing the character, printing the equivalent character in the display. Up to this, this makes BF is equal to 0. After the data processing is over, this flag BF, busy flag, is made as 0 by the LCD. So by reading this busy flag, I can send the second data. This technique is used here. So these are the initialization codes. So the 380E010686, these are all initialization codes. So after that, I am not using the delay subroutine. Instead, I am using only the command subroutine. Okay, so this is the data. So when I move the G and then O, I am using only one subroutine called display subroutine, DISP. Okay, up to this, the main program ends. Now we check the subroutine. So in command subroutine, first of all, I am calling one more subroutine from here to check the ready status of the LCD. Before sending any command or data, we have to check the ready status of the LCD by reading the busy flag. Okay, so when we read the busy flag, the busy flag's data is obtained from the D7th pin of the data lines. So what is the pin we are connecting? We have connected to D7th pin is P1.7. So P1.7 is the pin used for checking the busy flag. Okay, now we jump from, we call the ready subroutine. Hence we move to the ready subroutine. Now what we do, P1.7 is going to act as a busy flag. Hence I am setting as a input pin. Then I am clearing the, that means I am going to read the command. Hence I am going to make RS is equal to 0. R by WR bar is made as 1 because of the read operation. Then it will go for, whenever we read the data, we have to make the enable pin transition from low to high. Generally in write operation, we perform the enable pin transition high to low. When we read the data or command from the LCD, we have to make enable pin from low to high transition. This is done here. After that, I am checking P1.7 is 1. It is not. Hence, it go back to the this label and performs again 0 to 1 transition, checks for P1.7. Okay. So when this condition fails, that means when it becomes 0, it comes out from the subroutine and return to the command subroutine. Where it returns the command subroutine, then the data is moved to next command, data is moved to P1. As usual, we perform RS is equal to 0, R by WR bar for write operation, then enable high to low transition. Similarly, for data display also, we call the read subroutine. The similar things we do before sending the next data, we check the ready pin. So these things happen. Whenever the LCD finishes the data processing, it makes this pin as 0. When this condition is failed, it will return to the data subroutine. Then we move to the next data. For example, G is already sent to the LCD. After printing the G character in the LCD, that LCD device makes busy flag as 0. If the busy flag is 0, it come out from the ready subroutine and the display process, the second display process starts. Means O is now starts printing. Okay, so remaining things, as usual, RS should be made for 1 for data, R by WR bar should be returned 0, enable pin should be made high to low transition. Okay, so this is the second type of program by using the busy flag checking before sending any data to the LCD.